In quite a large room right now. The Enlightenment is the name given to the age of reason, discovery, learning, and flourish from the 1680 to 1820. Changed the way that people viewed the world. Enlightened men and women believed that the key to unlocking the past and mysteries of the universe lay in directly observing and studying the natural and man-made world. Their passion for collecting objects from fossils and flints to Greek vases and ancient scripts was matched by their desire to impose order on them, to catalog and to classify. So this entire exhibit is called The Enlightenment. And this gallery presents seven important Enlightenment themes. You can visit them in any order, but if you wish to follow the themes in sequence, the cases are numbered. The cases along the walls are filled with objects grouped by type. These help to convey a sense of how objects were organized and displayed during the Enlightenment century. The objects displayed in this room were collected during the early years of British Museum, which was founded in 1753. They helped us to explore the passions and ideas of collectors and scholars at the time. When the British Museum was founded, it was a place not only of learning, but also of wonder. This gallery focuses on the museum's early collections, recreating the first sense of amazement and exploring some of the ways that people in Britain viewed their world and past. And just a quick panning of the room. There's vases, antiquities, different cultures. We have British kings and noblemen, and we have looks like a Greek goddess type of thing. I'm gonna pan this kind of sideways. And we're looking at Venus, Roman, 2nd century. How cool was that? Venus, 2nd century. And we're coming over to Charles Talmage. And then Richard Payne Knight, 1751-1824. Collector and trustee and benefactor of the British Museum. And we have Clive Runyon, from 40 to 50 AD, said to have been found near Naples from the collection of Charles Townsley. And here we have books, clearly 18th century, more antiquities. They look to be from all over the world, India, Persia. We have some Mayan. You know, clearly more Indian goddesses. We have Roman helmets. Sorry about the reflection, but this is just a quick introduction to the room. And more books. Yeah, more books, and I'm doing a pan on. We're looking at Jan Dashman. Jan Dashman Fawn, Roman, 2nd century AD. A senator. Okay, well, clearly we couldn't afford clothes back then. We're in pottery. Weaponry. Now here we have mosaics and carvings from marble. And we have pottery. We have more books. I never signed any of those, so the value is decreased. And we have all I didn't want to show you. And here we have stuffed animals. Wonderful. Looking like a stuffed blue heron. Woodpeckers from the world, falcon, barn owl.
I thought your ducks were barn owl, didn't
you? Yeah, we have ducks, geese, shark collection, giant clams, and we have a conch collection. I'm not reading any of this, so I'm just going off of basic knowledge. Oh, it looks like we have ostrich eggs, emu eggs, whatnot. And rolling over to more seashells. Again, we have a lot of conchs. And shells. Ooh, a platypus. Platypus from Australia or New Zealand. A marsupial platypus. I'm not sure if you can see them that well. Butterflies. Oh, we have the beetle. An Egyptian beetle. Oh, and a rare colorful bird. Beautiful.
Yeah, this would just be submission one, which is essentially one quarter of the room, and I'll start up another video. This will be part one on same subject. So stand by. Enjoy. Thanks. From D-Tone.